Call unto me, and I will answer. Call unto me, and I will answer. That is the word God has put in my spirit right now, and I had to promptly, and I say promptly for a reason, I had to promptly come to record the word. This is my service today, on this June 16th, when we as a nation in South Africa here, we were celebrating or commemorating the day when a certain amount of violence was perpetuated upon the youth on June 16th, this day, some years back. Obviously, there was a lot of bloodshed at the time. There was a lot of violence at the time. There was a lot of pain at the time because people were losing their children. People were dying, children were dying, people's peace was taken away, and we are commemorating that day today, June the 16th. But more than that, God says, call unto me, and I will answer. So now we can look at events like this, which happened in the past, and even now, events which are happening even today. And you'll wonder, where is God? Where was God then? Where is God now? Where was God then? Where was God now? Were people not praying? Were people not praying? Were they not seeking His guidance? Were they not looking for Him for protection? And in so doing, seeking that protection, did He answer? Did He answer? And if He answered, why did He let these things happen? Even now you might be asking, why are these things happening around me? You know, the thing about Christianity, and perhaps it's just about me actually being real for a second, is that things don't always go our way. And many people like to say that God works in mysterious ways and all those great and wonderful things. But fact of the matter is, some of the things that do happen, yes, God does allow them to happen, but it's not that He wants them to happen. But at the same time, He won't stop them from occurring. That is maybe the part of God or from God that we don't necessarily understand, but He knows what He's doing. He knows the food plans. He can see the future of that action. We cannot. For instance, all of the apostles, those who preached the gospel, many of them died very gruesome deaths. Yet these were servants of the Most High. You'd expect that God would protect them. Even Jesus Christ Himself, the Son of God, He had to die. Obviously, that situation is different, but He had to die. God could have stopped it from happening, but He allowed it. It was necessary, even Adam and Eve. Because God foresees all things. Even the Lamb of God was the Lamb that was sacrificed before the foundation of time, for an act that was not even yet occurred. So God knew in advance what would happen. So He could have again prevented Adam and Eve from falling. But He allowed it. To an extent, He allowed it. And I will say to an extent, because there is this notion of free will that you must still understand, that God can't force Himself onto you. But in your actions, because the thing about God is that He cannot preempt you from acting. And that's an important word. He cannot preempt you from doing what your thoughts or what your mind wants to do. Because you still have, even prior to that error that you're about to make, prior to that sin that you're about to make, you still have the option to say no and to back away from it. It's the same, if I can put it in this terms, it's about testing. Yes, it's about your faith, definitely. But it's also about understanding about the decisions that you make and also the consequences that come from it. Obviously, in the situation of June 16, the consequences came from the fact that a certain amount of children or people gathered to strike, which was nothing wrong with that. And on the other side, a certain people in power gathered to stop them from striking. So it was a case of opposition, action and reaction. I don't know if they could have done it in any other way. I honestly don't know if striking is always the answer, as we're seeing in the States right now, where violence has been perpetuated in these situations. I don't know if that is the best solution, but as a result of people gathering for even if a good cause, there is going to be a reciprocal response from the authorities, who are also going to respond in a particular way. So now you ask yourself, can those things be prevented, and can God interfere, and can God actually do something about it before things get out of hand? And the answer to that is yes. People could have stayed home. People could have practiced wisdom. The police officers themselves could have practiced wisdom. If they were born again, they would have known not to use such force. So God could have spoken a word to them. And even if you're not born again, God speaks a word to everybody. You don't have to be born again to hear from God, but it's up to you. Again, it's about choice and free will. It's up to you what you decide to do in the moment. But God can prevent you from making that choice, because you might actually, or you can still, or you have the right, or you have the ability to make the right one. So again, God cannot preempt you to say that he's about to sin, let me do this. He has to allow you to do it. It's a scary thought, but he has to allow you to sin, so that then the consequences thereof and the thoughts thereof and the actions thereof can be taken care of. Again, it's a little bit hard to explain, but that's just the reality of the situation. God can't stop you from doing things, even if those things are going to harm you. Some of the things that we do, actually most of the things that happen to us or occur around us, are from our own doing. But at the same time, in it, God gives us the opportunity to repent and come back to him. Again, it's a trust issue. He's not going to force himself onto you. He's not going to pull you away from that thing. You need to make the decision. Salvation in itself, the most powerful thing on earth, salvation itself is about choosing God. Even the presence of God right now, like I can feel God's presence, it's about me choosing him to be upon me and to work himself inside of me. It's a choice he makes. It's a choice I make. And it's a choice he also makes to say that he's going to come to me. So he chooses to come to us. But we also need to choose to receive him. So even in this situation with the riots going on and whatever else is happening around the world, people are choosing. It's not that God is not talking to them and not asking them to stop doing that, whatever it is that they're doing. He's speaking a word to them of peace and joy and happiness and a good future. He's speaking those words over everybody, but not everybody is listening. And because they're not listening, they're going to do certain things and they're going to be repercussions from those things that are happening. Question then is, do innocent people get caught up? And absolutely they do. A lot of children, for instance, get caught up in these situations and they get hurt. They get hurt, they lose their protection, and they lose, many of them lose their childhood. And I'm sure even some of you have lost your childhood, your childhoods and the joy from your childhood, from what your parents went through, from what you went through at your schoolings and whatever around us. So people do get hurt. But in that hurt, it does not mean that God ever left us. In those situations, you'll find if you go back, God was there somehow. Either was trying to speak a word of peace inside of you, or he was trying to find a way to get you out of the situation in one way or another. But again, people do not always listen. So God is always looking for an opportunity to present himself to you. Even now, whatever's happening around us, he's looking for an opportunity to present himself to you. But will we listen? Do we listen? There's a scripture that says, if my people turn away from their ways and turn back to him, he will hear their prayers. But it's a case of they need to turn. It's not that God can't answer those prayers. He can. But if you, in your decision making, even after he's answered the prayers, you choose to do sin and you choose to do wrong, then God answering those prayers is pointless, because you're still going to go your way. So sometimes God has to pull himself away from you so that you may face the consequences of your actions. And then you may also know that if you decide to come back to him, he's there. He will listen. Even in the situation that you're doing those things, God is there. So you can actually, even in the moment, choose to turn back, and he will listen and he'll protect you. But again, it's a choice. So what's happening around us right now, it's about choices. It's about actions and reactions. Actions and reactions. So let us not blame God. Not saying that he is not to blame to some extent. He's the one who made everything after all. So to an extent to another, he is to blame, because this is his world, this is his earth, this is his creation. But as far as us fully pointing the finger at him, that we cannot do. Because we have choices, and he allows us to practice those choices. Again, it comes down to free will. It comes down to free will. You're not his prisoners. You're not his slaves. You're not his puppets. You have a choice. So everything that's happening around you, ask yourself, what role do I play in all of this? And what role have I, or in terms of what extent have I stopped God from moving? in this situation on our behalf or on my behalf or my family's behalf? What have I been doing to prevent that from happening? What is your role? What is your role? Don't be angry with God. Don't be angry with God. There's a lot of things happening on this earth which are negative, which are not nice. He sees them. He's not happy with any of them. But again, his hand is limited because people do not listen. Make sure you're one of the few who is listening so that he can use you to help him to get to some of those people and to help some of those people in those situations to get out of it. Or even if it's just to protect you from those situations so that eventually people will know that, yes, things did happen. There was something bad that occurred, but I was saved because I heard from God and he saved me like Noah. God spoke. Noah listened. He adhered. He was saved. He did not force himself onto Noah. Noah had to listen and follow the instructions from God. So you listen. Whatever is happening around you, forget what's happening around you, because people will do what they want to do at the end of the day. You listen. You listen and you do what God is asking you to do, and it shall be well with you. I know this is not a common message, but it's a message I felt I needed to preach. As I said, I was promptly brought here so I can just align you back to the Word of God, the Spirit of God, your relationship with God. Make sure it is maintained. Make sure it is maintained. Be blessed.